Hi everybody, housing is coming to Hastings. As you can see behind me here, we are in a housing boom as we speak right now. We're at Heritage Ridge in Hastings off General Sieben Drive and Fallbrook Drive. This is one of the many developments that we've seen within the city of Hastings over the last couple of years. The development we're seeing here is 116 homes, comprised of single family homes and what are called villa homes, which are like a detached townhome design. This development is under construction. We have many building permits and great demand within the subdivision, and it will be filling up with those houses within the next couple of years. This is not the only subdivision going on in Hastings. When you take a look at our housing growth, over the last 10 years, we had about 470 new permits for housing units. Within the next 2 years, we should see over 600. So we're seeing much more growth in a lot more areas of development, from single family to apartments to senior development. And I want to highlight a few of those here today. Beyond this development, we also have another villa home project that's being constructed on Northridge and Pleasant Drive called Villas at Pleasant. That's another 32 units that's being marketed towards empty nesters and seniors. That's under construction as we speak. We also have a couple of apartment projects going on right now in the senior category. We have The Quill, which is at Schoolhouse Square. This will be 90 units of affordable senior housing, independent living, that will be under construction beginning this fall. There is also the Vermilion Acres project, which is located on County Road 47 by Riverwood Drive. That'll add another 75 units of housing, which will be comprised of both dependent living and memory care units. So a little different market there for the senior set. We also have some projects that are under construction on the apartments, considering downtown with the Confluence project. The Confluence is the former Hudson Manufacturing property. As you cross the Hastings Bridge, across the Mississippi, it's the big factory. There's 18 units that are under construction there for apartments in conjunction with the hotel, banquet facility, and restaurant that's going on at that facility. We also have a lot more things on the horizon as well. We're looking at review of a 32-unit apartment project within the downtown that'll be going to Planning Commission coming up very shortly. And we also have another project of property that our Hastings Economic Development and Redevelopment Authority owns at the old UBC site that we're looking at another 80-unit apartment building there. That could be under construction in the spring along with the Seward apartment project. We're also looking at other annexations as well. Annexation is land that's brought into the city for new development, kind of like what we see here. Down on the south end of the city on Highway 316, we will be having shortly another 160 homes that are being proposed to be brought into the city at County Road, Highway 316 and Michael Avenue. So that'll be something that'll be coming forward for approvals over the winter and under construction in the spring. One of the interesting things about Hastings and housing is the affordability factor. With the housing stock we have being in varied ages, we have a lot of affordability. Our Economic Development Department just went through a study in which we looked at the affordability of housing that's present and found that we do have a lot of affordable housing, more than our peers. So when you take a look at some of these senior projects, apartment projects, the ability for folks that have lived in Hastings for a long period of time to move into other housing to make housing available for new families is there as well. So we hope that the housing we have will hit a lot of different markets and there'll be more to come. So this is a summary that I have of the housing. If you have any questions, you're looking for more information, we've got information on our website, or please call the Community Development Department at City Hall. Thank you.